Hello everyone, myself Dr. Ravi Agrari and you guys are listening me on Purvanchalize online platform. As you know, this Purvanchalize is a sustainable education platform and we are providing you both online and offline both classes. It's very nominal fees. So as a sustainable education platform, Purvanchalize is welcome to everyone. Here we are not only providing you science and technology environmental module, even complete GS courses are available at very nominal fees. For online courses, even a part of this for offline or face-to-face classes, a very economical institution has set up in Gorakhpur, UP. If you are interested, so you can contact on the given number for both online and offline classes. This is the lecture number 12 of Science and Technology, and here I'm going to start with Unit 2, Energy. In this energy chapter, there are three dimensions. And all these three dimensions will cover in this entire discussion, guys. There are around 10 to 12 lectures is required to finish this complete energy chapter. This each and every video, as I told you guys in this platform, will be around for 1 hour. Okay, just few plus minus minutes. So let us start, guys. What type of three dimensions which are necessary to complete your whole chapter? Okay, and then finally, if you see your question paper, guys, every question of prelims and mains you will solve. Okay, so there are three dimensions in energy that you have to start. The one dimension where you have to discuss about concepts, basic concept of energy, where lot of fuel are energy sources. Even what about the present use of energy sources? What about the future use of energy sources? As I can tell you guys, alternative energy sources, solid, liquid, gaseous nature of fuel we are using right now. For future perspective, you know, renewable energy have a good future. Even fuel cell, microbial fuel cell, biomass gasification, thermal battery, lithium ion battery. Okay, fuel cell, microbial fuel cell. In that way, guys, this entire portion, the first part will over. Later on, the second dimension will be here in energy that I make at a separate topic that will come as nuclear energy. The second one will come as a nuclear energy. So that will be the second dimension in this entire energy chapter. And third dimension will be a separate topic, and that is connecting with IR. I mentioned this chapter in my book as a nuclear diplomacy. This nuclear diplomacy topic is connecting with IR somehow. What will come in nuclear diplomacy? Concept of IAEA, International Atomic Energy Agency, and additional protocol, nuclear supplier group, NFU, no first use, NPT, CTBT, Wassenaar arrangement, NPT, CTBT, Wassenaar arrangement, Australia group, MTCR. So this type of part. Those are always in news, guys. Even in 2019, UPSC asked one question from IAEA in a prelims paper. Similarly, NHD was also a prelims paper question in 2019. So there were two questions in your paper in 2019 prelims from IAEA and additional protocol and nuclear supply group. Even this energy, if you see, guys, for the prelims paper and mains both, you know, what about the weightage in complete science and technology? In prelims examination, at least 3 to 5 question on an average. And in your mains paper, at least 1 question in your paper. Energy based. So this is the reason this chapter is very, very important. Either you go for prelims or mains examination. A part of these three parts. One more dimension which is required for this entire lecture, guys. for the discussion. What is this? Many government schemes and programs. Many government schemes and programs that brought especially for energy. Okay, like I can tell you, like Pehel scheme. Just few, I just to introduce it, like that type of Pehel scheme. Give it up campaign. Give it up campaign. Ujwala. Ujala. NELP. HELP. Hydrocarbon Exploration Licensing Policy. New Exploration Licensing Policy. Net Metering. Bureau of Energy Efficiency Star Rating. And so on, guys. So in that way, this complete energy chapter will over. It is a very lengthy chapter. At least here I will make 10 around videos. And every videos will be at least 1 hour. 10, I'm telling you, it's minimum. It can exceed more. And in that way, this complete entire energy chapter will over. So what about summary of this chapter that I will cover here? I hope you understood many dimensions. And what is here, I hope you people know very well. After completing, okay, after completion of every chapter, even I will also discuss every question papers regarding every chapters, and that all question paper you will discuss with me. Even first 6 video, those I uploaded on this Purvanchalize platform, that is free for everyone. And just it will enough to open your eyes, guys, ki what type of dimension you should cover in your preparations. Syllabus and question paper, open your eyes. Okay, so now let us start, guys, with this lecture number 12, this first portion of energy. How we define energy? How we observe energy, actually? First, you see how we observe energy. See, there are 2 types of observation in the aspect of energy. Okay, with 2 terms. What are these 2 terms? One term that is called as caloric value. And second term that is called as calorific value. So these are 2 terms that in the beginning everybody should be clear. So whenever you start energy, you should be clear with these 2 terms, caloric value and calorific value. How to describe caloric value? Caloric value is what? This is the food energy. Caloric value is what? This is food energy. What about calorific value? Calorific value is the fuel energy. Calorific value is a fuel energy. How to describe food energy and fuel energy? Okay, just a minute, guys. Caloric value is actually used for food energy, and calorific value for fuel energy. How it is? See, guys, when 1 gram food dissociate inside your body for energy generation, this is called caloric value. And similarly, when 1 gram fuel burn inside the vehicle, that energy generate, this is called fuel energy. Okay, see how to describe caloric value. You see here, guys, suppose 1 gram fat, 1 gram carbohydrate, or 1 gram protein, whatever you eat up, guys. After the consumption of fat, carbohydrate or protein, those energy generate inside your body. That's why you people are doing your work. You are living. Your body have energy. This is your caloric value. And how to describe calorific value? 1 gram fuel burn inside a vehicle. Any unit you can take, guys. 1 gram, 10 gram, 100 gram. But you compare every nature of fuel with the similar units in 1 gram, yeah, 100 gram, yeah, 10 gram. It is up to you. How to describe calorific value? When a 1 gram fuel burn, energy generate, this is calorific value of that fuel. 1 gram of coal burn, 1 gram of petrol burn, 1 gram of CNG burn, 1 gram of LPG burn, 1 gram of hydrogen burn. So ultimately calorific value is what? That is your fuel energy. And on that basis, your vehicle have a mileage. Actually, this entire lecture is based on this science and technology. And this portion is actually part of biology. This portion is a part of biology. In this lecture, I'm going to describe you this concept of calorific value. Okay, so I hope in the beginning, everybody very clear. What about the basic difference between caloric value and calorific value? Now, we'll go into the discussion of study of energy on the basis of various parameters. You come? Study of energy on the basis of various parameters. So, two parameters you should know. Your civil services made question paper. So there are two parameters for the study of energy. One, resources. Study of energy on the basis of resources. Second, study of energy on the basis of utilization. Study of energy on the basis of utilization. Resources based, you can see here guys, like conventional and non-conventional energy sources. Conventional and non-conventional energy sources. And what will come on utilization basis? You say utilization basis, behavioral and non-behavioral. Here resources basis you come second side, okay, based on resources. Here you can say as renewable and non-renewable. So I hope you got it guys. Two parameters for the study of energy. The one, study of energy on the basis of its utilization, conventional and non-conventional. Second, study of energy on the basis of resources, renewable and non-renewable. Okay, now question is, resources means what about the source for this energy generation? Utilization means your use in behavior that we are using it, guys. Even whenever I'll go into the discussion of conventional, non-conventional, the picture will be very clear. First you come energy study on the basis of resources. That you can see here, renewable and non-renewable. What will come? See guys, you see basic difference between renewable and non-renewable. Renewable energy sources are those which we can use again and again. These are those energy sources which we can use again and again. Why you can use it again and again? Reason, these are inexhaustible. Reason, these are inexhaustible. Inexhaustible means this type of energy sources will never lose. Do you know guys, what about the example of renewable energy sources? Solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy. Last year, ocean energy also considered as a renewable energy. Biomass energy. So this type of energy sources will come under renewable guys. These are those which we can use again and again. Okay, everybody. Inexhaustible, this type of energy sources never lost. Both two statements are complementary. And one thing more guys, which is benefit of renewable energy. Whenever you will use the solar energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy, you know what type of benefit? This type of energy sources will have a no pollution, a minimum pollution. This type of energy sources will have no pollution or minimum pollution. And just see non-renewable. What will come in non-renewable? We cannot use it again and again. If once you will use it, so it will not left for your users. Do you know about the example of non-renewable? कोल, पेट्रोलियम प्रोडक्ट्स, नेचुरल गैसेस, दिस टाइप ऑफ एनर्जी सोर्सेज विल कम अंडर द पार्ट ऑफ नॉन रिन्यूएबल गाइस. कोल वंस यू यूज इट विल नॉट लेफ्ट फॉर योर यूजर्स. सिमिलरली पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैसेस. So this type of, these type of energy sources, we cannot use again and again. One point. Second, it means these are exhaustible. It will exhaust. These are exhaustible. No pollution or minimum pollution. What will come here? They create pollution, guys. When coal burn, when petroleum products burn, in these cases have a lot of pollutions. And mostly these coal and petroleums are those which we are using worldwide. You know, which is the main source of energy worldwide? Coal, guys. Around 60% power generation in the world, it is because of burning of coal. And burning of coal-based power generation is called as thermal power plant. So 60% around power generation worldwide, it is because of coal, thermal power plant. Okay, everybody. Fine. And even in India, guys, still coal have a good contribution in power generation. Even every year economic survey published, and every year you should see this data for your updations. Around 58-60% power generation still in India, it is because of thermal power plant. It is because of thermal power plant. And one thing more, guys, that UPSC asks in your paper, from thermal power plant, when coal burn. Okay, see, UPSC prelims 2011. What was the question in UPSC prelims 2011? Okay, from thermal power plant, which type of polluting gases emit in the atmosphere? One, CO2. Second, SO2. Third, NOx. This was mentioned in your paper and then had options. A, B, C, D. 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. So this is the one question, guys, that UPSC asked. Even you can say this question is connecting with pollution chapter. So from burning of coal, which type of polluting gases emit in the atmosphere? UPSC question. And see here, you should remember, guys, all three emit in the atmosphere. So D option will write. And here these two gases at CO2 and NOxes, you know, these are global warming gas. But SO2 is not a global warming gas. SO2 is considered as a global cooling gas. And this concept I will discuss with you in environment chapter. Means environment subject. Whenever I will discuss with you. Okay, so that is from thermal power plant. Which type of polluting gases emit in the atmosphere? All three gases. CO2 and NOxes are global warming. Sulfur dioxide is a global cooling gas. Okay, behind global cooling have some more reasons. But it is a part of environment, not in science and technology. Okay, so I hope you understood, guys, that worldwide how much pollution is going to generate because of thermal power plant. Even 60% worldwide power generation is because of this source. So massive pollution worldwide is because of thermal power plant. Okay, guys, fine. Now, what about one thing more, guys, you know, nuclear energy will also come under non-renewable. Nuclear energy means where we people burn uranium, thorium, plutonium, those are called as a nuclear fuel. So nuclear energy here, main source of energy are what? Nuclear fuels like uranium, thorium, plutonium, and they have also in limits, guys. When you utilize uranium, when you utilize thorium, when you utilize plutonium, it will loss. And next time it will not left for your users. So in that way, I can tell you guys, these are non-renewable. You cannot use it again and again. Okay, everybody? Fine. In that way, I can tell you these are exhaustible. Okay, and these all you can say as a what? Non-renewable. If even natural gases, those are available in the nature. If you use once, again, it will not left for your users. Okay, fine. Now, question is conventional and non-conventional. This type of terms you will also find many places, guys. Conventional means those energy sources which are in behavior. which are in behavior. Those we are using in our life normally. They are easy to use. These are direct to use. Non-conventional, not in behavior. Non-conventional, not in behavior. So non-conventional means these are not in behavior. Reason, these are not easy to use. These are not direct to use. Now I have a question, guys. You tell me, those energy sources we are using normally in our life is a conventional? It is your answer, guys. You tell me, renewable we are using everywhere or non-renewable we are using everywhere? So of course you guys will tell me non-renewable. 60% already is because of coal, petroleums, natural gases. Okay, actually, if coal and petroleum you consider, so massive energy requirement of your guys will fulfill because of these two, and these two consider under non-renewable. So this is the reason I can tell you, non-renewable are generally non-renewable are generally considered conventional. So what are conventional? Mostly non-renewable consider under conventional, because 80% around coal and petroleum fulfill your requirement of power generation, your requirement of energy needs. Okay, so I hope you can understand. Okay, fine. And similarly, what, and I said generally, not always. Reason, contribution of natural gases and nuclear energy is very less in India for energy generation. Even guys, this time, what about the contribution of nuclear energy in India for power generation? Do you know? 3-4% nuclear energy. In whole contribution of power generation in India. But with time, India have some vision. What with time India's vision? India's nuclear vision, I will tell you guys, India's nuclear vision of India. And this nuclear vision is for 2050. Do you know what about in this nuclear vision 2050? That is 3-4% power generation of nuclear energy, it will reach by 25% around. So a great contribution by nuclear energy in coming future by 2050 nuclear vision. So this time, those nuclear energy 3-4% as a non-renewable. Okay, as a non-renewable. And what? This is not considered as a conventional, because the share of this nuclear energy in the power generation in India hardly 3-4%. But other like coal and petroleum, you consider as a conventional. So I am telling you, in coming future, those nuclear energy right now is 3-4% in power generation. By 2050, it can exceed up to 25%. So in 2050, it is possible we can consider nuclear energy also as a conventional. So this is the reason. Most of the cases of non-renewable considered as a conventional, generally, yeah, mostly, but not always. Reason, nuclear energy and natural gases not in this category. It means, guys, with time, in coming future, scenario will change, and that updation is required for you guys. Okay, and another one. What will be the non-conventional? Those are not in behavior. I hope you can guess very easily, guys. Renewable like solar, wind, tidal, geothermal, ocean, biomass. These all are what? These all are non-conventional. How many of you people are using solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy, ocean energy and biomass energy? You tell me. Solar energy, maybe somebody will give me example. Maybe some Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, somebody's can give me example of also wind energy. But not conventional, not in behavior, not everybody's are using. Only up to certain extent people started to use it. So what about the conclusion of this discussion? Renewable and non-renewable, basic discussion, basic differences we have seen. One more, generally non-renewable are conventional, and generally renewable are non-conventional. So this is the conclusion where you can understand renewable, non-renewable, conventional and non-conventional. Now, next concept. Study of energy, next heading, study of energy on the basis of calorific value. Study of energy on the basis of calorific value. So next heading, study of energy on the basis of calorific value. And this order you follow, those I'm writing here, guys. Number one, I will mention coal. Number two, petroleum products. Combinedly, I mentioned all petroleum products in at second level. Next one, I will tell you LPG. Next have CNG. And then next have hydrogen. In this order, you note down, guys. So number one, coal. Number two, petroleum products. Number three, LPG. Number four, CNG. Number fifth, hydrogen. Okay. I mention only those examples which are very common in your surroundings. Yeah, those you are listening, we will use very soon in coming future, like hydrogen fuel. Okay. See, guys, coal, then petroleum products, then LPG, then CNG, and then hydrogen. Okay, see. Coal have minimum calorific value. Coal have minimum calorific value. And hydrogen fuel have maximum calorific value. So what you will get in this order? From top to bottom, calorific value is going to increase. Minimum calorific value, more here, much more, and very high here, guys, highest. It means from top to bottom, calorific value is going to increase. Again, I repeat, 1 gram fuel burn energy generated. This is calorific value of that fuel. Even someday, one of the students, many students told me, those never believe on teacher, okay. They told me, sir, you know, on Google, CNG is upside and LPG is given downside. Then I said, guys, that Google-based material I also have seen. So again, I'm telling you, those mentioned here, you follow it. If you can understand chemistry, if you know chemistry, you can understand, guys, from top to bottom, what is going on? The weight of fuel is going to decrease. If you know LPG have a propane and butane, C3H8, C4H8, C3H6, C4H8, this type of fuel we are using in LPG. And CNG is what? CH4. And CH4 is lesser, guys, in weight in comparison to C4H8. So this is the reason those order I mentioned, you follow. That material I also have seen on Google. Okay, you follow LPG and CNG. I have seen it, guys. Many places it is mentioned, but you follow it, guys. So coal, petroleum products, LPG, CNG, and hydrogen. Okay, fine. My another question is, guys, those fuel you have seen on the basis of calorific value. If I ask you how many nature of fuel you are using, so you will get it, three nature of fuel we are using. What are three nature of fuel? Coal is what? Coal is solid nature. I hope everybody know. Coal has solid nature. What about petroleum products? Liquid nature. And what about LPG, CNG, and hydrogen? Gaseous nature of fuel. So now in this conclusion, I can tell you, we people are using all three nature of fuel as solid, liquid, and gas. We are using all three nature of fuel as solid, liquid, and gas. Everybody clear? Fine. And what about another conclusion? Another conclusion, those you will get here, guys, gaseous nature of fuel have maximum calorific value. All three lower part of the example are gaseous nature. And you got it, guys, the upside to downside, what is going on? Calorific value is increasing. So how you will conclude? How you will conclude? Gaseous nature of fuel have maximum calorific value. Many plus and minus about gaseous nature of fuel, I will discuss in next video. Here in this video, my topic of discussion is solid nature of fuel, that is coal. So in this entire video, I will finish you guys coal. Later on, we'll go into petroleum, LPG, CNG gases in next video, because my every video will be for 1 hour. Okay, fine. See, guys, all those fuel mentioned here in chemistry, these all are called as the hydrocarbons. Reason, they are made up of carbon and hydrogen elements. And this is the reason they are hydrocarbon as a molecules. So in chemistry, those fuel you can see here, guys, they are the hydrocarbons. Okay, Fine. Now your heading will be coal here, guys. Next video will go for petrol, and then LPG, propane, butane, CNG have a methane, hydrogen have a hydrogen, then hydrogen fuel cell, microbial fuel cell. Okay, in that way, next video. But here, coal only. Okay, coal. Your next heading, coal. So what you got it here? All are hydrocarbons. So coal is also a kind of hydrocarbons. This is made up by carbon and hydrogen compound. My question is, guys, how many types of coal? Slowly and gradually, you will understand every concepts. Do you know how many types of coal? In economical geography, NCERT geography book you read it. I hope you guys know very well. Okay. I hope you know 4 types of coal. Okay. Order wise, tell me, guys. Order wise is very important. Then you will get many concepts here, guys. Order wise. Okay. The first coal, you know, that is anthracite. According to order. The first one is anthracite. Second coal is bituminous. Second coal is bituminous. Third coal is lignite. And fourth coal is peat. These are 4 types of coal in your surroundings. Again, tell me, what are these 4 types of coal which are available in nature? The one anthracite, second bituminous, third lignite, and fourth peat. According to this order, you remember, guys. Anthracite, bituminous, lignite, and peat. And all are what? Hydrocarbon. All are made up by carbon hydrogen compound. Okay, see another one. So all are hydrocarbon, and everyone is made up by carbon hydrogen. Made up by carbon hydrogen. Now see, guys, in every types of coal, those you can see here, guys. In every types of coal have carbon content, and amount of carbon content varies, and that's why the nature of coal varies. If you see anthracite, bituminous, lignite, and peat, everywhere amount of carbon content varies. Peat is that coal, guys, where the amount of carbon content is less than 35%. Peat is that coal where amount of carbon content is less than 35%. Anthracite is that coal where amount of carbon content is more than 85%. So this is less than, and this is 85% plus carbon content. Okay, so it is less than 35%. This is more than 85% amount of carbon content. So all different types of coal, carbon content varies. And what is here, guys? More than 35% up to 55%. So more than 35% up to 55% carbon content. Where? In the case of lignite. More than 55% up to 85% carbon content in the case of bituminous. And see, in that way, your examiner will never ask you how much the carbon content. Okay, so I just erase it and just give you a concepts. Where in the case of peat, you have seen the amount of carbon content is less than 35. Here, amount of carbon content more than 85. It means from top, bottom to top, if you go, amount of carbon content is going to increase. It means minimum carbon content in peat and maximum carbon content in anthracite. Everybody clear? Everybody clear? Okay. Next concept. So carbon content varies. Later on. Even guys, next difference on the basis of burning efficiency. Burning efficiency. See next difference. And burning efficiency will change on the basis of amount of carbon content. It is proof in chemistry, guys. Even if amount of carbon content is maximum, if amount of carbon content is maximum, so its burning efficiency will be maximum. If amount of carbon content is minimum, it means its burning efficiency is minimum. So again, what you got in this conclusion? From bottom to top, burning efficiency increase in this type of coals. In these type of coals. Now, result. Now, last result. If burning efficiency maximum, if burning efficiency minimum, so what about result? See guys, if burning efficiency maximum, so heat generation will be maximum and smoke formation will be minimum. I will give you one example, and that example you can see in your life, guys. In winters, during winter, you burn wood and see comparison at different nature of burning of wood. Comparison, different nature of burning of wood. If wood is burning slowly, not effectively, okay, in that duration of time, what happened? When wood is not burning effectively, in that case, more smoke is towards you guys and less heat in that moment of time. But what happened when you give some more wood, yeah, extra kerosene there, what will come there, guys? Burning efficiency increases. If fuel burn effectively, in that case, what will come? Heat increases, but smoke decreases. Similarly, those concepts you can see when you burn wood during winter, guys, same you can see here. If burning of coal is maximum, in that case, heat generation is maximum and smoke formation will be minimum. I hope you can connect that concept with this concept. And that burning of wood, burning of pual, burning of biomasses in winters, it is very common in most of the household, guys. If you belong some rural areas, so definitely you have seen. Maybe you belong to some very rich family, you never have seen that type. You know, some activities people are doing, like I don't know what is in higher society, people are enjoying this burning of wood, and then in the surroundings, oh, didn't know what is that term we are using it. Fire boom, yeah, what is this? I don't know, it's not recall right now. So I hope you clear with this concept. Maximum burning, more heat, less smoke. And what is here, guys? Heat is minimum because here burning efficiency is worst and smoke formation is maximum. So what you got in this conclusion, guys? In this conclusion, you got it. The peat is the worst quality of coal. And what you got it? Anthracite is the best quality of coal. I hope you can understand this logic very easily on the behalf of this entire discussion. And you know, guys, what about India's scenario? India is among 5 top most producers of coal in this world. Top most 5 producers of coal in this world. India is standing, guys. Okay, but still India import lot of coal from foreign countries. You know, logic. India is also among good coal importer nation in the world. Why India is among good top most importer nation in this world? Do you know? The reason is because we don't have best quality of coal. India does not have best quality of coal. India have average and below average feature of coal, that is bituminous and lignite. So which nature of coal that India have in maximum anthracite India does not have? You know which country have a maximum anthracite? You see, every year the data can be changed, but I got that is USA. US have maximum anthracite in this world. Even Australia still have a good amount of coal. Australia is very lucky country, guys. Many resources, Australia is rich. Even uranium. Which country have a maximum uranium? Australia. And you know, guys, 1/3 of uranium worldwide, those uranium available, 1/3 is only in Australia. 1/3 is only in Australia. So how much uranium in Australia? I hope you understood. Rank 1. Okay, so India have average quality of coal. And there is a reason, guys. There are few limitations with Indian coal. There are few limitations with Indian coal. What about the limitation? Yeah, problem with the Indian coal. What about the problem in the Indian coal? One, guys, our coal produces less heat and more smoke. More smoke. This concept you can connect very easily. If you don't have best quality of coal, so of course our coal have a problem. Which type of problem? Less heat and more smoke. This is a limitation with Indian coal. Okay, everyone, fine. Now नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. इवन गाइज इन वन एस्पेक्ट आवर कोल इज बेटर देन अदर वन कोल्स, अदर कंट्रीज कोल, दैट आवर कोल हैव लेस अमाउंट ऑफ सल्फर कंटेंट. Our coal have less amount of sulfur content, and this is the reason when our coal burn. So here amount of sulfur dioxide gas will be less. So amount of sulfur dioxide emission will be less in this case of our burning of coal. And I told you guys when coal burn, which type of pollution? CO2, SO2, and NOx. 2011. But what is the positive in the respect of Indian coals? Indian coal have a less amount of sulfur content. It does not mean that bituminous and lignite have a less sulfur. No. Other countries, those have a bituminous and lignite, they have good sulfur. But Indian bituminous and lignites have sulfur content very, very less. So don't be confused here, guys. And you know, guys, if I'll ask you in the CO2, SO2 and NOxes, which gas directly create a problem to human and nature, yeah, environment. So you remember, guys, highly effective among all these three is a sulfur dioxide, because it's directly strike you people, guys. It will come in your body through inhale, your circulatory system, nervous system, directly affect because of sulfur dioxide. CO2 NOxes, indirectly they create massive problem. They will go in atmospheric gases, increase the atmospheric temperature, global warming, coastal areas submerged, okay, malaria type of incident increases. In that way, CO2 NOxes create the problem. But sulfur dioxide directly hit. Not only in living beings like you people, guys, even also affect plants. Plant will lose their own chlorophyll. That is called chlorosis. Photon the stop, plant die. Dwarfism. Stunting, overall growth of the plant reduces. In that way, guys, sulfur dioxide create massive effect to the living organism, either you say human or other plants. Everybody got effect because of this. Everybody clear? Fine. So one more news according to recent current issues. What about the recent current affair news that India is that country in the world where have a massive sulfur dioxide emission? Now both statement that India have a less amount of sulfur dioxide emission after burning of coal, and the another statement those I am telling you that India is that region in the world where sulfur dioxide gases emission is maximum, both are looking contradictory. What was that current affair news, guys? What was that current affair news in the reference of India? Actually, guys, thermal power plant those set up in India for power generation, where we are using coal as a fuel, guys. Here various filter we are using worldwide. Those filter technology India use, our filter technology is not good among other nations. That is the reason after burning of coal, even amount of sulfur dioxide gases are less, but they come in the atmosphere. But other countries, those are using burning of coal, their amount of sulfur dioxide gases are more, but still they restrict through the help of their own filter. That's why the emission in the atmospheric gases decrease, but from India side increase. So that was current affair news in July 2019, July August around it was in news. So I hope that news you will never confuse. And this is the question, problem of Indian coal, less amount of sulfur content. It was also UPSC question 2010 prelims. At least 2 to 3 question now you have seen that UPSC has in your paper. Even guys, this coal and all nationalized during Indira Gandhi government period, and those coal mines government provide to any companies, it is not on the basis of lottery system. You know, many coal mines, Colgate corruptions, you people got it in news few years back. Okay, so actually those coal mines government provide to any company, guys. Here it is not on the basis of lottery basis that government will issues a lottery, on that lottery basis this government will sell their own coal mines. No. Even either it is a spectrum. Okay, that I will discuss in the communication chapter, guys. Spectrum, either it's a coal, guys, either it's a spectrum of frequencies in an information communication technology based topic I discussed, and the second one, guys, coal based. Both are through open auctions, not on lottery basis. Open auctions. And that open auction government will organize. On that basis, company will come, and those company will give maximum value for this coal mines or spectrums. Those I'll discuss in information communication technology. Government will sell them. So this was a question in 2018 or 2019. So one question, 2011, burning of coal. Second question, problem Indian coal. Third question, 2018. So now how many questions you have seen? Three question, UPSC question. Even slowly and gradually, your every question will solve, guys. You just wait, trust me. And I never trust on you. You trust me, but I never trust on you. That's why I will solve every question in front of you in this entire discussion of maybe 60, 70 hours lecture. Okay, and I don't know any shortcut. I also told you guys, I always follow Hanumanji. Hanumanji never knew, guys, where this Sanjivani Bhuti in this hilly regions. So what he has done, he brought the complete hills, guys, because Hanumanji never wanted to give second attempt. In that period of time, maybe it was possible that Lakshman will not survive. So this is the same condition here. When you join my course, so I will give you the entire knowledge of a subject and entire discussion of question paper, either it's a prelims or mains. My focus is 11 to 19 prelims, 11 to 20 prelims, and 13 to 20 maximum mains question paper. That will be enough for your 2021. Okay, everyone, fine. So this is the entire discussion. I hope you can understand. One thing more, guys. You know, India is third largest consumer of electricity in the world. You know this statement or not? India is the third largest consumer of electricity in the world. And with time, our energy demands are increasing day by day. Yes, we have need of lot of infrastructure growth. Building, monuments, bridge constructions is still required to run our industries. Our population increases, resources are more utilized. So power generation is requirement is more and more and more. And India is the third largest consumer of electricity in the world. This time I'm telling you. And with time, our energy demand is going to increase, increase and increase and increase, guys. If one day I will say to everyone, stop to use energy sources. One day I just request to everyone, stop to use energy sources. Do you know, guys, your life will stop. Your life will stop. How your life will stop? You just see. You tell me how you people come in at any institution. Through bike, metros, buses, trains. Now you cannot use. Because these all run through energy. Energy sources. Okay, fine. Second, those mobile phone you are using, guys. What is the source? Power. Those are consumed inside battery. Now you are not applicable to use it. Reason you told me that for a day you will not use any energy sources. So you cannot talk to any of your loved one, guys. Reason, phone is not allowed to you. If suppose any accident happen, so how you will move to a hospital? Because through even to hospital, guys, some energy fuel is required. Now that how through vehicle you will reach to a hospital. Okay, fine. Hospital is near to you. You can give me this excuse. Okay, fine. Hospital is near to you. 3-4 people hold this person and put it into the hospital. Okay, fine. In hospital, how surgery is possible? Power is still required. So in hospital, all operations, surgery, everything will stop. Okay, leave it, guys. Throughout day, you will be hungry. Because those food you cook, it also use LPG, propane butane. But I told you, don't use energy sources. Now you tell me, how much energy is required for your life? See, guys, your life will stop. Even how you people are listening me, how you can do this preparation, guys. through online. This is also running through what? Power, energy sources. So without energy, your life will stop. Without energy, your economy will not grow. Industries and all those are running, guys, in India. They all are running through the help of power sources. So I hope you understood how much the mean of energy in your life. And this is the reason, guys, India is working a lot for the coming future. For what? Power generation. If somehow India is thought that's very difficult to generate energy and to fulfill the demand of Indians, guys, India wanted a member of energy nuclear supplier group. So how smartly a concepts are connecting with the other concepts. Okay. Slowly and gradually you will learn with me, guys. So it's not factual. Even here, guys, not only UPSC, even every state PCS question also covered here. Whatever the state PCS question, which is the best coal? Anthracite. Which coal have a maximum carbon content? Anthracite, factual. Which gas burn in LPG? Propane, butane. Which smell in the LPG cylinder? Ethyl mercaptan. That discussion I will do in the next video, guys. Because today in this entire video, my topic of discussion was only coal. Only coal. And next video, I will go into the discussion of liquid and gaseous nature of fuel. And gaseous nature of fuel, I will discuss many of them, guys. Few you people have seen LPG, CNG, hydrogen. Few like shale gas, gas hydrates. Gas hydrate, you know, that was a question paper in 2019 that you can call as a clathrates. Okay, so that discussion I will do in the next video. Okay, and you people follow entire videos in this order, guys. This entire video will be helpful to you. So thank you, everybody. I will stop here right now. If you want any kind of contact, so these numbers are given here. You can contact on coaching shoots regarding our online offline classes. So take care of yourself, guys. Meet you soon in the next video, lecture number 13, where this liquid and gaseous nature of fuel will again take around 1 hour to complete this part. Okay, thank you, everybody. Have a good day. Take care.